Good morning all. Now today onwards I am going to start HSC class 12th. HSC class 12th last 10 years papers. Last 10 years paper solving 10 years papers. Chapter wise I am going to solve it. So first chapter we are taking Mathematical logic. So we are going to solve last 10 year questions of this mathematical logic. Okay, now let me know first, you know the idea of mathematical logics all? How many of you don't know? Tell me fatafat. Like you don't know conjunction, disjunction, implication, by implication, negation. How many of you don't know? Be frank. Tell it. If you don't know, say no problem. How many of you don't know? Nahi pata? As you don't know the basics, actually I suggest you go through videos, go to the mathematical logic, I explained everything in detail. So I will not explain that much detail right now. So you go to the first chapter, in detail I explained, everything I explained. Even deleted syllabus also I explained, circuits is deleted. But you go and study that then. If you not study then, there is no use of that teaching all these things. And it is the one of the wonderful lesson, you not required of class 9th or 10th or 11th any basics. And this is a wonderful lesson, if you don't know multiplication, division also, you will learn this chapter. That's not easy chapter and scoring for your boards, it is scoring of 8 to 9 marks. And JE it is 4 marks. See here, okay, every statement, see here. Every statement, like a P is a statement, mathematical statements or many things are there. Not only mathematical statement. Any statement, let us take as sun rises in the east, like Delhi is the capital of India. Like you are taking a statement. The statement, every statement has a true or false. Okay. We can say it is a true or false. Okay. That is only we can say, right now. So can I say that Mumbai is the capital of India? It is a statement, but it is true or false, you have to tell. So every statement has true and false. Okay, suppose I said as 2 plus 3 is equal to 6. But this statement is a false statement. So remember that if it is one statement, there will be having options true or false. If I have two elements, suppose I have two statements. I have two statements, then what are the possibility to get out? See here, if you are tossing two coins, then what are the things going to happen? Both you get head. Both you get tail, one head, one tail, and the first one head, tail and head. Likewise, if you have two statements, you get the chances of true, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. So remember this one. If it is one statement, you will be having true, false. If you have two statements, you will be having true, false, false, true, false, false. If you have three statements, then what do you have? Truth value. These are the truth values. One statement have two truth values. Two statements have four truth values. And three statements have eight truth values. 2 power 1, 2. 2 square, 4. This is 2 cube, 8. In this what will be there? Here true, 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 true. False, 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 false. And next will be have true, true, false, false. True, true, false, false. This will be true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. These are the truth values of the statement. If we have one statement, true, false, two statement, this is the combination, three statements is this. If one statement is combined with another statement, then you get a compound statement. One statement is combined with another statement, you get a compound statement. If I started P and there is a Q statement, I added a connection AND. This is represents AND. Okay. So if I connected with this AND, that is called compound statement, P and Q. This is also called as what? conjunction or disjunction? Conjunction. We call it as conjunction. And if you have like this, then this is called as disjunction. Two statements are connected with the or. This is the symbol for or. And two statements are connected with implies. Implies. Then this is implies we call. If P, then Q. So if then situation you get, then this is P implies Q. And then another one is P by implies Q. So two statements are connected with this. This symbol is called if then, also called as implies. And this is called as by implies, also called as, this is what we can say as if and only if, IFF, if and only if. Every conjunction, these all statements have the truth values. So truth values, truth table will be there. These compound statements have truth values. Like if I take P and Q, P, Q are the two statements. As I told you, if P, Q are two statements, their truth table will be T, T, F, F, T, F, T, F. And if I want to get AND, I already told you like this here, there is a road. I had explained you this diagram. There is a road and a car. You have two gates here. One gate is here and one gate is here. And you are reaching your home here. Okay, this is your home. And if two gates, TT means two gates are open, you can reach the home, so true. The first gate is open, second gate is closed, you cannot reach the home. First gate is closed, second gate is open, you cannot reach the home. Both gates are closed, you cannot reach the home. So here AND condition is T and T will give you T. T and T is gives T. These small things also you don't know means these many days what you have done. And next one is PRQ. When you have R, R means R condition. When you have like this R, this is called, previous one is called conjunction. This is called as disjunction. When you have R here, then we can say this. When you have R here, then you will be having the road like this. This is your home. This is your home. And there is a junction. So that's where this junction. So there is a junction. And you have a car. Okay. You have a car. You are going traveling there. True, true. This gate open, this gate open. You can go reach your home anyway. This gate is open and this is closed. You can reach by this way. True. And this first one is closed and second one is open. You can reach home. Both gates are closed. Then you cannot reach home. So FRF is equal to F. FRF. FRF will give you F. So this I explained to you, right? Next one is implies. And this is important for JE also, right? And I explained these, all these things. You have to watch the videos. And this topic is a very easy topic. P implies Q. See, I am teaching now fast. If you see that time, you can see that video slowly. You can, so that you learn it. And a P, Q you have, and the table for P implies Q will be T, T, F, F, T, F, T, F. What happened? Okay, in this what I will get, TF will give you F, remain all the time TT. It's a conditional statement, condition. If P is T, then Q is F, then you will get F. Only this case only, conditional, this is the condition. In this case, I will get F, remain times it is true. So if TF is F, then remain is F. Other times FT is T, TT is T, FF is T, but TF is F. Okay, are you getting it? And then the another one is P by implies Q, the last one. So here okay, so T, I do this one only. That's better. What I do here? Now, in this case, when I take the by implies, plus into plus is what? Plus. Minus into minus is what? Plus. So, like T, T will give you T, F, F will give you T. But if it is T, F will give you F, and F, T will give you F. Like here, minus into plus, plus into minus is minus. This time is minus, this time is minus, this time is plus. Okay, that's what you have to know. And then other thing is, next one, you should know is negation. Negation means what? I think problem is chalk. When you have negation, so this is P, negation P here. See here, any statement you have, TF, one statement will have truth values, that is TF. The negation P will be what? T is becomes F, F will becomes T. If you have again negation of negation P, negation of negation P, it means that for this negation you have to apply again negation. So F will become D, T will become F. This is FL. So here you can understand that P is equivalent to negation of negation P is equivalent to that. Understood? It's a basic idea. That's after that.